Yep, that's right. I died and lost all of my stuff.
The Wither. 4 soul sand and 3 wither skulls creates this monstrosity. It drops the all-important nether star, which is used to craft a beacon. Some people consider it as the hardest boss in Minecraft, and I decided to take on this beast and get that all-important nether star. Spoiler, things did not go as I thought they would go. In other words, they did not go to plan. Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode. As you can tell, I'm going to be fighting the Wither. I have all of these potions ready, brewed, just in case we need it. Let's just say, I fought this thing in Bedrock Condition before, with 2 of my friends, with full Prow 4 armor, and we got destroyed. Now, note, this was like on our 4th month of playing Minecraft, but still, we got destroyed, so I'm ready for, I've got all these potions ready, I've got gapples, I've got all the marbles. I think we should spawn this beast. I mean, why wait, I guess? Let's do this. Whew, alright, here we go. Witherin Heights. I'm very, very nervous. Oh, I'm smart, I'm extremely smart. Okay, that's speed 1, you've gotta be joking. I'm so bad. Okay, I'm so smart. I'm definitely really smart, no. We'll just cut that part out. How about that? Let's actually hit this guy maybe with our bow. Oh my god, this is doing so much damage and I'm taking like no damage. What is this? What? Dude, I'm... What? What? Okay. I was completely overprepared. First of all. Okay, and now should be the easiest part, right? Now I can easily use my sword. Wait, there's no way this is gonna be this short. That's not right. No, come on, that's not gonna happen. I mean, they can't, no. They made the Wither fights completely different in 2 different editions. Well, we just beat the Wither. All right, I've got some inventory cleaning up to do. And I'll be back at my house with that all-important nether star, and we'll be all good. Everything will be in order. All right, here we go. We craft the beacon. Okay, that's going immediately in the ender chest. I'm not losing that. All right. So there's something that I've been working on that I need to show you guys. Well, not working on, that I've actually finished. And this is something that I should have gotten a while ago. I should have made a while ago, and that's an iron farm. Now, it's actually pretty efficient for its size. It produces about 1 block of iron per minute. For some reason, like, when I log on, it takes about 10 minutes to start. Don't know why. I'm not a pro, but as you can see, I've got a stack of iron blocks, stack and a half of iron blocks, and I've got this gold. And you might be wondering, R3D3, how'd you get so much gold? Well, you see, I did some mining off camera. We have a public gold farm on the server, but you'd be surprised to know that actually only 20 of those gold blocks that you saw are from the gold farm. I mined the rest. That's how efficient it is to just get gold from the nether. Anyways, of course, this iron farm is insane and I'm super happy, but the real reason I needed it was because of the beacon, and I needed some kind of ore for the beacon to get to work, and so I decided I need to make an iron farm, and yes, I did make it with my friend. I have Thorn's armor, which happens to be really, really annoying when trying to get a zombie in, but yeah, I made it with a friend. And I'm actually going to show you guys, like, a test. It's not faultless. The iron farm's not faultless. Sometimes it does mess up. But I'm going to show you guys a test of if I were to AFK for 5 minutes, how many blocks of iron I get. So, yeah, let me show you that right now. All right, I'm starting the countdown. Okay, there's already 12 iron in there. So I'm going to take that away. Okay, and I started the timer. Here we go. Well, I'm actually going to put all of my stuff in this chest. So just in case I die. It's just a precaution. Anyways, let's do this. Alright, it's been 5 minutes, and there you go, 42 iron. That is actually average. And one iron golem's dying right now. So that's going to be around 45, which is exactly what I said, one block per minute. Let me grab all my stuff. Alright, I got all my stuff. Oh, 47. There you go. That's actually two more than average. And yeah, that's the iron farm. It is awesome. It does have a few faults. Okay, there's another four. It does have a few faults. For example, sometimes iron golems can get stuck in that corner right there. But yeah, otherwise, I have fixed a lot of them. I'll tell you, there's been a lot in the start. There was a lot of faults. And yeah, I have to show you one more thing. In the last video, we started a villager trading center. And it is thriving. I've got a... That's actually... Okay, let me show you the overview. So I've got a mason over here. And he's been extremely... We've used him a lot for those clay trades. It's super good. Sharpness 5. Thorns 3. And over here, I've got a cleric that somehow died. I stole his bed. Because he died. Unbreaking 3, I kept his bed there because as like a shrine. I don't know how he died. I don't know how they keep dying. It's just sad. I have a care farm I just showed you. Riptide 3, ignore the signs. Whoops. Let's get the villager. And efficiency 5, it's 58 emeralds. That's a problem. And there's also a farmer that used to be here. Okay, so I thought of like a project idea that I could do. And this project idea involves that really ugly area over there. And I thought, why don't I terraform it and make it cooler? And I have a beacon now. And I've got all the gold and iron to supply the beacon for haste too. So I thought, let's terraform this area, put some walls, do the cool stuff. And yeah, here we go. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe. If you don't, you'll be bad. Bye.